弟兄姐妹，大家早上平安。
Good morning, Shalom, Brian sisters.
很高兴今天可以在这里跟大家分享。
I'm very glad to share with everyone today.
昨天我们读完了列王记上。
Yesterday we finished reading about First Kings.
所以接下来我们休息一下，下个礼拜再读列王记下。
So let's take a rest, and also next week we'll start reading Second Kings.
今天我们要看的是诗篇一百三十二篇。
And today we look at Psalms 132.
这一篇呢，也是上行之诗。
It is also one of the song of ascents.
诗篇里面有十五篇上行诗。
In Psalms altogether, there's 15 songs of ascents.
然后今天这一章呢是十五篇里面最长的一篇。
And today this psalm is one of the longest in the songs of ascents.
但也只有十八节。
But altogether is only 18 verses.
今天我把它的主题定为渴慕神同住。
So I give it a title that is to desire for the dwelling place of God.
在第五节看到诗人写道，只等我为耶和华寻得所在，为雅各的大能者寻得居所。
In verse 5 it says, until I find a place for Jehovah, a dwelling place for the mighty one of Jacob.
13, 14节讲到，因为耶和华拣选了锡安，愿意当作自己的居所，说这是我永远安息之处，我要住在这里，因为我所愿意的。
Verse 13 and 14 it says, For Jehovah has chosen Zion, his desire for his dwelling place. This is my resting place forever. Here I will dwell, for I have desired it.
我们看到这里呢，大卫非常渴慕来为神建造他的居所。
And we see that David really desired to build a dwelling place for God.
也看到耶和华怎样拣选锡安，也很非常乐意的住在锡安，就是他的居所，大卫所为他预备的居所。
And also how Jehovah has chosen Zion as well, and also is very pleased to dwell in the dwelling place that David has built for him.
这一篇诗篇呢，也是讲到大卫之约的一篇。
It is also the song of the covenant of David.
所以我们就来看，我们是否也渴慕与神同住呢？
So let's look at this. Do we also desire to dwell together with God?
我记得 John 小的时候常常就跟我们说。
And I remember that when John was young, he would often say this to us.
他每次都说，等我长大之后，我要做一间很大很美丽的房子，我们要一起住在一起。
And he would say that when I grow up, I will build a very big and also beautiful house so that we can dwell together.
然后我说，你长大过后，你结婚呢？怎么办？
And I asked him, when you grow up and also get married, what happened?
他说，所以我要做一间很大的屋子，我们全部人都住在一起。
So I want to build a very big house so that all of us can dwell together.
因为他渴慕跟我们同住，一直都同住。
Because he desired to always stay together with us.
所以我想大卫也是一样。
And I believe the same goes to David.
他为神建造居所，因为他非常渴慕神一直跟他同住。
He wants to build a dwelling place for God because he wants God to continue to stay with him.
所以我们就来看今天这一篇。
So let's look at the psalm today.
这一篇呢，我把它分为两段。
And I divide into two paragraphs.
第一到第十节。
Verse 1 until verse 10.
这里是讲到大卫向神许的愿。
And here it talks about how David has vowed to God.
我给他的小题为神纪念大卫所付出的。
And I give it a subtitle that is God remembers what David has contributed.
11到18节是讲到神向大卫起誓。
And verse 11 until verse 18 says that God has sworn to David.
小题为神向大卫平城时起誓。
And thus the subtitle is God has sworn in truth to David.
那这一篇是谁写的呢？
So who has written this psalm?
作者没有很清楚的说明。
We are not very sure about the author.
可是可能从这个内容里面，我们可以推测可能是所罗门。
But from the content, we can deduce that it's most likely Solomon.
因为第六到第九节，他讲到我们怎么样安置这个的月柜在圣殿里面来看的时候，有可能是大卫他建造了圣殿，把神的月柜放进去的时候所做的一首诗。
Because from verse 6 until verse 9, it says that I'll place your Ark of the Covenant in your temple. And therefore, it's most likely Solomon after he's built a temple and also put in this Ark and write this psalm.
而且呢，第八、第九、第十节呢，它的内容跟历代之下六章四十一、四十二节非常相似。
And also we see that the verses here are very similar to 2 Chronicles chapter 6.
就是所罗门在献殿的时候的祷告其中一段。
It is the prayers of Solomon when he dedicated the temple.
所以有可能是所罗门写的。
So it's very likely that it can be Solomon.
我们就来看第一段一到十节神纪念大卫所付出的。
So let's look at the first paragraph, God remembers what David has contributed, verse 1 until verse 10.
这边第一节到第五节讲，耶和华，求你纪念大卫所受的一切苦难。
In verse 1 it says that, Jehovah remember David and all his afflictions.
什么苦难呢？
So what kind of affliction is this?
第二到第五节他就说，他怎样向耶和华起誓，向雅各的大能者许愿，说，我必不进我的帐幕，也不上我的床榻，我不容我的眼睛睡觉，也不容我的眼目打盹，只等我为耶和华寻得所在，为雅各的大能者寻得居所。
Verse 2 until verse 5 it says, How he swore to Jehovah and vowed to the mighty one of Jacob, Surely I will not go out to the chamber of my house or go up to the comfort of my bed. I will not give sleep to my eyes or slumber to my eyelids until I find a place for Jehovah, a dwelling place for the mighty one of Jacob.
这首诗一开始就诗人就求神呢，纪念大卫因为爱神，因为爱神要寻求神的居所所受的一切的苦难。
At the beginning of this psalm, this psalmist has already mentioned and asked God to remember David and also the affliction that he encountered because he wanted to build a dwelling place for God.
大卫也向神许愿说，如果还没有找到这个居所呢，我就不睡觉，就不休息，不打盹。
And David also vowed to God that if I do not find this place, I will not give rest and also I will not sleep.
证明大卫要建殿的心志呢，非常的决心啊。
It means that David was very determined to build a dwelling place.
他不是只是许愿就忘了，他许了这个愿，他真的是实践出来。
He was not just making this vow, but he made this vow and also want to come bring it to pass.
大卫呢，他要带路，把约柜带入耶路撒冷的动机是非常的单纯的。
And David's motive to bring this ark into Jerusalem was very pure.
因为我们知道大卫的故事，他从小都非常渴慕跟神在一起。
We know that David since young really desired to be together with God.
所以呢，他邀请约柜同进入耶路撒冷呢，不是因为要约柜跟帮他打胜仗。
So when he wanted to invite the Ark of the Covenant into Jerusalem, it was not because he wanted the Ark to win the battles for him.
也不是因为什么政治的手段。
Or any kind of political schemes.
不是要别人说，哦，我的国度多么巩固，你看我有神的约柜在我的当中。
And for other people to see that, oh, you see, my kingdom is so stable because I have the Ark of the Covenant, God's presence.
他乃是知道他真的需要神住在他的里面。
But he truly knew that he need God's presence to dwell in his midst.
所以他承诺他一定要办完这件事。
So he has vowed that he need to accomplish this.
其实当时候大卫在执政的时候，
At that time when David was ruling,
他是战胜连连。
He has battles and victories over victories.
然后政治稳定。
And politically it was stable.
经济富裕。
And economically, it was flourishing.
但是他想到自己住在镶白木的华丽宫殿里面。
But when he thought about he was dwelling in this splendid palace of cedar wood.
但是月桂呢，反倒放置在一个微不足道的幔子里面。
But the Ark of the Covenant was placed inside a veil in an insignificant tent.
所以他就非常的心痛，他要为神来建造殿宇。
So David really have this heartache and really want to build a temple for God.
虽然后来呢，神不要大卫为他建造殿宇。
Although later God didn't want David to build a temple for him.
但是是由他的儿子所罗门所建造的。
And it shall be done by his son Solomon.
但是呢，大卫为神预备了所有建殿的材料。
But David has prepared all the materials for the building of the temple.
这就是大卫对神的心。
And that is David's desire towards God.
如果我们再推前一点来看，原本，约柜不是在耶路撒冷。
If we look at the history, initially the Ark of the Covenant was not placed in Jerusalem.
我们知道月柜就是依表神的同在。
We know that the Ark represents the presence of God.
在摩西时代，月柜在哪里，神就在哪里。
During the time of Moses, wherever the Ark was, there was the presence of God.
然后呢，云柱火柱带领着以色列人前行。
And also the pillar of clouds and also the pillar of fire leading the Israelites to advance forward.
月柜一直都在以色列的百姓当中。
And the Ark of the Covenant continued to be among the people.
而且由祭司来供职。
And the priests will actually minister to it.
但是有一段时间呢，月柜不见了。
And there was a period of time when the ark was lost.
是发生什么事情呢？
So what actually happened?
原来在一段时间，这个月柜呢被带到去基列野林。
So there was a period of time when this ark was placed in Kirjath-jearim.
所以第六节他说，我们听说月柜在以法他，我们在基列野林就寻见了。
So in verse 6 it says that behold we heard of it in Ephratah we found it in the fields of the woods.
为什么会在基列野林呢？
So why is it in the fields of the woods or Kirjath-jearim?
然后在那里待了多久呢？
So how long has it stayed over there?
我们就可以回溯到撒母耳记上。
So let's go back to 1 Samuel.
之前我们也刚读完不久。
So we also read it in our morning
devotion. 所以大家应该有印象。
So everyone must have remembered it.
在士师时代的时候呢，以色列人跟非利士人常常征战。
During the time of judges, the Israelites always have war with the Philistines.
所以当时候的长老就出一个主意说，不如抬月神的月柜一起上阵，就必定得胜。
So the elders gave an idea to carry the Ark of Covenant into the battlefield and to have the victory.
所以呢，那时候以利的两个悖逆的儿子就是何弗尼还有非尼哈。
So at that time, the two sons of Eli, that's Hophni and also Phinehas,
就把神的月柜带去一起征战。
Carry the Ark of God and also to go out to war together.
结果呢，这个月柜就被非利士人掳走了。
And this ark was captured by the Philistines.
如果大家记得非利士人拿到这个的月柜的时候，他们的偶像就跌倒粉碎。
If everyone remembers this, that when they carry into the temple of Dagon, the idol actually fall down on their face.
然后他们的人就生痔疮。
And the people actually have tumors.
哇，结果辗转多折，最后月柜呢就去到基列野林。
And after a lot of turns, and then they send this ark of the covenant back, and it was placed in Kirjath-jearim.
所以撒母耳记上七章二节就讲，月柜在那里放了二十年。
And in 1 Samuel chapter 7, it mentioned that it was placed there for 20 years.
但是呢，二十年之后是撒母耳还有扫罗兴起的时候。
But after 20 years, it was the rising of Samuel and also of King Saul.
但是扫罗做王到大卫再起来做王呢，又隔了五十年了。
So between then, it was about 50 years before David actually rise up as a king.
所以应该月柜在基列野林有七八十年的这么久啊。
So I believe that the Ark of the Covenant was placed in Kirjath-jearim for 70, 80 years.
所以一个月柜已经被一个国的主要的政治中心还有宗教中心被遗忘的一个月柜。
So this Ark of the Covenant was forgotten by the center of religion and also the center of politics.
已经放在基列野林七八十年。
It's been placed in Kirjath-jearim for 70, 80 years.
但是呢，扫罗做王的时候完全没有想起要把月柜运回来。
But when King Saul was being the king, he never thought to bring the Ark of the Covenant back.
是直到大卫做王稳定了他的江山之后呢，就要把神的月柜运回进来。
It was when King David was king and also he was politically stable, he wanted to receive of the Ark of the Covenant back.
要把它运到耶路撒冷。
And to transport it back to Jerusalem.
就是大卫城，就是大卫他建国的时候的首都。
And that is the city of David, the capital when he actually built the nation.
也可以称为是锡安。
And also called as Zion.
所以这个是大卫的心，他常常纪念神的同在和神的约柜。
And that is the heart of David. He always remembered God and also the Ark of the Covenant.
难怪圣经称大卫是合神心意的人。
No wonder the Bible describes David as a man after God's heart.
的确，我们如果去以色列，我们知道什么都 King David, King David. 这个又是大卫王的城啊，那个又是大卫王的product 啦，产品啊。
So if we go to Jerusalem, we can see that there's a lot of products that's labeled as King David's product.
因为他们真的是以这个王为傲啊。
Because they are so proud of having this king.
因为唯有大卫王，他真的是非常合神的心意。
Because David was really after God's heart.
他是主动亲近神，主动为神建造居所的王。
He proactively draw close to God and also want to build the dwelling place for God.
而且在他的整个人生，他都是没有离开神的。
In all his life, he has never left God.
所以呢？就看到大卫的心智，他真的是只等到他为耶和华寻的居所，为雅各的大能者寻的居所，他才可以安歇。
And we see that David truly he can only rest when he find a place for Jehovah and also the dwelling place for the mighty one of Jacob.
接下来七到十节就是诗人在唱说，我们要进他的居所，在他的脚凳下下拜。耶和华，求你兴起和你有能力的月柜同入安息之所。愿你的祭司披上公义，愿你的圣名欢呼。求你因你仆人大卫的缘故，不要厌弃你的受膏者。我们看到在这里呢，他说不要厌弃你的受膏者，表示呢王就在这个的唱这首诗歌的队伍当中。
In verse 10, it says that do not turn away the face of your anointed. It means that this king is in the midst of those who sing this psalm.
以后的王呢，以后的世人呢，他们在唱这首诗歌的时候，都在纪念大卫曾经做的这件美事。
And later, the kings or anyone else who sing this psalm will remember what David has done.
大家都好像扯大卫的这个的衣服边说，神啊，你看大卫为你这么用心哦，为你建造殿宇，所以求你也顾念我们啊。
It's like everyone would just mention David and say that, look, God, remember David, and therefore you also remember and also be gracious to us.
所以当大家在唱这首诗歌的时候，其实也在提醒自己，哎，真的是要效法大卫，真的是大卫所做的，我们也要这样去渴慕。
As everyone is singing this psalm, they are also reminding themselves, yes, we also want to desire just like David and also to desire of the Lord.
我们渴慕神的同在吗？
Do we desire for God's presence?
还是我们更喜欢跟其他的东西同在？
Or do we desire to be in presence with other things?
是不是钱呢？
Is it money?
可能做生意的人因为要赚更多的钱，所以暂时呢，请神回避一下。
Maybe the businessman want to earn more money and therefore ask God to just take a leave first.
因为要做一些不干净的手段。
Because want to do something illegal, perhaps.
或者是我们非常爱炎热，也请神说，哦，神，你暂时去 holiday 一下，我也想 relax 一下。
And perhaps we really love indulgence and we will tell God that God, you take a vacation first, I just want to indulge myself.
那到底我们渴不渴慕神常常一直都跟我们同住呢？
Do we truly desire for God to always dwell together with us?
我们知道如果我们有 housemate 的其他的人，就真的是可能相处容易，同住难啊。
And we know that as we have housemate, it's good, it's easy to have interaction, but difficult to dwell together.
如果我们说，哦，要神跟我们一起同住，那我们的什么 pattern 哦，神都知道啊。
If we want God to dwell together with us, God will know all our patterns.
可能有些人不自在，不喜欢。
Maybe some people will not feel at ease and don't like this.
但是我相信有更多的人是非常渴慕神同住。
But I believe that there's more people who desire for God to dwell together.
我们回想起初我们圣灵更新的时候。
And we recall when we were being renewed by the Holy Spirit.
真的非常非常渴慕神的同在。
We truly desire for the presence of the Holy Spirit.
不管哪里有特会啊，有福星特会啊，恩高特会，我们都非常想要去参加。
Wherever there's Holy Spirit conference, anointed conference, we will desire to go and attend it.
因为想要真的是 tap in 神的同在里面。
Because we want to tap into God's presence.
所以不只是在本地啊。
So it's not just locally.
也去到邻国新加坡啦。
We also go to Singapore.
更可以更愿意付钱啊，坐飞机去香港啊
，and even pay the money and take the plane to Hong Kong，
台湾啊
，Taiwan，
甚至美国啊
，and even United States，
就是要进入神的同在
just to go tap into the presence of God.
真的是渴慕神
and truly desire for God.
付上很多的代价
and pay a great price.
有些人就是储蓄啊，祷告啊，就是想要去圣地啊
and some people save out and also pray and want to go to the Holy Land.
因为真的是想要渴慕，哎，神住在哪里？我也想去看，去体验。
Because we want to see where God has once dwelt and also want to experience it for ourselves.
真的渴慕，那这渴慕会引导我们去行动。
And our desire will cause us to take actions.
我们的眼，我们的心在哪里，真的我们的脚就会去哪里。
Wherever our eyes and also our hearts are, then that our feet will lead us there.
因为亲身经历神，就像大卫。
Because we personally experience God just like David.
不是跟风, 真的是很渴慕, 所以愿意付上一切的代价。
It's not just following the trend, but we truly desire and therefore willing to pay the price.
如果跟风的人可能跟到一半就不见了。
Those who follow the trend, they will just lost at halfway there.
但是真正经历神的人呢, 会一直跟到最后。
But those who truly experience God, they will follow until the end.
而且愿意 亲自遇见神,
they are willing to personally encounter God.
亲自经历神,
personally experience God.
想要更知道神的心意,
they want to know God's will even more.
2004年, 牧师还有 Pastor Amos, 我们的属灵父母, 就建立了GA。
In the year 2004, our spiritual parents, that is Reverend Esther and also Reverend Amos, has built GA.
建立教会之后, 他们的心就想为神建殿。
After they build this church, they want to build a temple, a sanctuary for God.
他们带领我们一起非常渴慕神的同在。
And they lead us to truly desire for God's presence.
愿意把神邀请居住在我们当中。
And to invite God to dwell in our midst.
然后这个的渴慕到神就感动我们，告诉我们要买哪一片土地。
This desire has come to an extent that God even told us which land to buy.
然后呢，我们 也因着我们的渴慕，神也在四方八面呢运财宝进来，让我们可以完全的买下这一片土地，是不用贷款的。
And because of this desire, God has transferred wealth from all around us so that we can buy this land without any loans.
最后，我们就建了这个很漂亮的祷告帐幕。
Last but not least, we build these beautiful prayer tabernacles.
每个人来到都感受到神的同在非常的。 非常的强烈。
So everyone can feel the strong presence of God here.
因为这是很多人的祷告, 很多人渴慕神同住所建立起来的一个神的居所。
Because it's a dwelling place after the prayers of many people and also the desires of many.
然后这个帐幕呢, 就是面向以色列的。
And this tabernacle is facing Israel.
真的我们牧师的心和眼都是向着神。
Reverend Esther's heart and also her eyes are facing towards God.
在我们启用这个祷告帐幕的那一年就是2010年10月10号。
And on the day that we started to use this tabernacle, and that is October 10, 2010.
也是我们的6周年堂庆。
It was also our sixth church anniversary.
甚至牧师定这个堂庆，这一年堂庆的主题是神的帐幕在人间。
Reverend Esther has set the title for this church anniversary as God Tabernacles Among Men.
真的，我们邀请神跟我们同住。
As we invite God to dwell together with us.
我们弟兄姐妹一起同心祷告，付上的一切的代价。
Brothers and sisters has prayed together and also paid the price.
就是为了神住在我们当中。
It is for God to dwell in our midst.
不是说神一定要住在什么豪华的地方。
It's not to say that God needs to stay in a very luxurious place.
如圣经所说的，神对大卫说：“我不是要住在什么豪华的香柏木的殿宇。”
And just like how God has told David, I don't have to dwell in a luxurious place in the palace of the cedar woods.
我向来都是住在会幕和帐幕里面的，神说。
All this while I've been dwelling in a tabernacle.
所以神看重的乃是大卫的那一颗心啊。
So what God placed importance on is actually David's heart.
虽然我们付出了一切的代价，做起来的也是一个简单简陋的帐幕。
And although we pay all the price, but what we build is just a very simple prayer tabernacle.
不是豪华的殿宇。
It's not a very luxurious one.
但是最重要的，神喜悦。
But most importantly, God is very pleased with it.
因为这个的行动，这个的摆上，神 验中神看见。
And because we pay a price, we offer up, and therefore God has seen it.
现在我们还在计划要有第二期的建殿工程。
And now we are planning to build for our second phase, the house of prayer.
我们知道这些的实体的圣殿。
And we know that this physical temple,
其实是彰显我们对神的那个爱还有心意啊。
It's showing our heart and also our desire towards God.
我们愿意为神不眠不休付出一切来去建造神的圣殿。
We're willing to not rest and also to give sleep, but to build this temple for God.
所以我们不单只许愿说我们要，而更是呢，我们是行动去做的。
Not only do we vow and say to God that God, we want to do so, but we actually take action to do it.
所以我们现在已经办理了。
So we have totally moved away from Tataran Hamoda.
那个是我们游牧民族的时候，我们住在的地方。
And that was the place when we were living as nomads.
现在我们真的是定居在这里。
Now we are truly dwelling in this place.
我们要在这个神所给我们的土地上继续的建造。
We want to continue to build in this land that God has given us.
我们也让更多的弟兄姐妹。可以参与 用我们的心我们的行动来告诉神说我们多么渴慕神你同在
and cause more brothers and sisters to participate in this and using our action and also our heart to show that God we really desire for you
所以因着大卫的那颗心啊
and because of David's heart towards God
就来到十一到十八节神就向大卫平陈时启示
we have come to verse 11 until 18 that God has sworn in truth to David
大卫，耶和华就在这里跟大卫立约。
And Jehovah has sworn and also to vow to David.
这里呢也跟历代志上十七章，还有撒母耳记下七章是很相似的，就是他大卫之约。
And it is very similar in 1 Samuel chapter 7 and also 2 Chronicles chapter 7, that's the covenant of David.
耶和华向大卫平城时起了誓，必不反复说，我要使你所生的坐在你的宝座上。
Jehovah has sworn in truth to David, he will not turn from it. I will set on your throne the fruit of your body.
你的众子若守我的约和我所教训他们的法度，他们的子孙必永远坐在你的宝座上。
If your sons will keep my covenant and my testimony, which I shall teach them, their sons shall also sit on your throne forevermore.
真的，大卫的宝座永远他的后裔就坐在宝座上。
And truly, for the throne, David's descendant will sit on it forevermore.
这里有两个部分，一个部分呢是有条件的。
And here, there's two parts of this covenant. The first part is with condition.
就是谁可以坐在大卫的宝座呢
？And who can sit on the throne of David?
就是遵守神的约的人。
It is those who keep to the covenant, also testimony of God.
但是大卫的王朝哦是永不止境的。
But the throne of David shall be established forever.
是没有条件的。
And there's no condition for that.
所以这个应许呢，就在大卫的后代，就是永远掌权的耶稣基督的身上就实现了。
And the one who reigns forever is being fulfilled in Jesus, the descendant of David.
然后神在十三、十四节说：“因为耶和华拣选了锡安，愿意当作自己的居所，说这是我永远安息之处。”我要住在这里，因为是我所愿意的。
God in verse 13 and 14 says so. For Yehovah has chosen Zion, his desire for it, for his dwelling place, and this is my resting place forever. Here I'll dwell, for I've desired it.
神非常愿意住在锡安，就是大卫的住处。
God really desired to dwell in Zion, that's the dwelling place of David.
因为大卫的心
because of the heart of David.
锡安，它的意思是枯干之地啊，干枯之地。
Zion means the dry and withered place.
也是耶路撒冷的另外一个名字。
And also another name for Jerusalem.
就算是干枯之地、简陋之地，但是神看重的是心啊。
And even though it was very dry, withered, and also simple, God placed importance on the heart.
如果我们乐意为神建殿，神就非常乐意跟我们同住。
If we desire to build a sanctuary for God, God really desires to dwell with us.
其实神是看我们的回应。
And God actually look at our responses.
神巴不得要跟我们一起住。
God truly want to dwell together with us.
就好像我们父母的巴不得跟我们的孩子一起住。
And just like us as parents, we want to dwell together with our children.
只要孩子愿意，然后为我们建造一个的居所， 哇，我们就非常乐意跟他们一起住。
As long as our children are willing and also want to build a dwelling place for us, we want to dwell with them.
所以我们的上帝也一样。
And likewise, the same with God.
他不介意我们有什么 pattern, 什么软弱。
He doesn't mind all the patterns that we have.
他也不介意我们的房子是非常的简陋。
He doesn't mind that our place, dwelling place is very simple.
但是如果我们渴慕的话，哇，他就非常愿意住在我们当中，做他的居所。
But if we desire for him to come, then he will want to come as his dwelling place.
然后是永远安息之所。
It is a resting place forever.
哇，是非常的荣耀啊。
It is very glorious.
所以今天我们如果在新约时代呢，在新约时代我们看到，神呢也要使教会成为他的安息，还有荣耀的居所。
In the New Testament time, we see that God has made His church as His glorious dwelling place and resting place.
在以弗所书二章有说到。
In Ephesians chapter 2, it mentioned it.
教会就是众圣徒满有安息和祝福的居所。
And the church is the place where there's a lot of blessing for the saints and also the congregation.
我们这里就是教会。
And here we are the church.
所有圣徒聚在一起的地方就是教会。
As the saints gather together, that is the church.
我们同声来敬拜神的时候，神的同在居所就在这里。
As we worship God in one accord, then God's presence is enormous.
所以为什么就算在疫情期间，如果一可以开放回来的时候 ，Psalmist 就很愿意我们大家都回来，因为这里是教会，是神的居所。
And during the pandemic, whenever it is possible, Pastor Amos would really want to open up for branches to come back and also worship together.
如果政府可以让弟兄姐妹可以回来敬拜神的时候，我们也愿意呢，让弟兄姐妹回来敬拜神。
When the government allows for branches to come back and worship, we are willing to do so as well.
因为当我们这样子乐意的时候，我们顾念神的事，神也顾念我们的事。
Because as we are doing so, as we mind God's business, then God will also care for our matters.
我们就看到接下来神就大大的祝福大卫。
And we see that later God really greatly blessed David.
和他的后裔。
And also his descendants.
同样今天这些祝福也要临到我们的身上。
And likewise today all the blessing will also come to us.
当我们渴慕神同住的时候。
As we desire for God to dwell together with us.
我们会成为饱足丰满的人，使穷人都得饱足。
And we'll be abundantly blessed and also to satisfy the poor with bread.
真的，我们可以从何事上看到我们弟兄姐妹都饱足呢？
And how can we see that our brothers and sisters are being satisfied?
就在奉献上。
And that is in their offerings.
每次的奉献，首节的奉献，出熟的，大家弟兄姐妹的摆上，我们就看到，哇，弟兄姐妹真的领受神的祝福啊。
And from the offerings of brothers and sisters during the feast days, we can see that brothers and sisters really received the abundant blessing of God.
当我们渴慕神的同住的时候，神就为我们披上救恩的祭司的外袍。
And when we desire for God's presence, then God will clothe his priest with his salvation.
他会带领我们呢，带领更多的灵魂来归向神。我们每一个人都是祭司。
And he will lead more souls to God and all of us, we are acting as priests.
然后我们会成为得能力有权柄的人，就好像大卫救恩的脚。
And we'll become those who have the authority and also the strength, just like the horn of David.
我们有属灵的权柄，可以在这个地上跟神一起执政掌权。
We have the spiritual authority to rule and reign together with God.
然后呢，光明的灯就是我们可以为神发光啊。
And also a lamp for his anointed, that is, we can shine together for God.
神会为我们击打一切的仇敌，但是我们头上依然有这个的冠冕。
God will attack the enemies for us, but on our heads, there's still the crown that will flourish.
所以好不好呢？
Is it good enough?
非常好哦，当我们愿意跟神同住。
It's so wonderful when we're willing to dwell together with God.
当我们愿意建造神的居所。
When we're willing to build a dwelling place for God,
神就把这一些的祝福都祝福我们。
God will use all this blessing to bless us.
所以前几天大家都写了很多的祷告文在这个棚子里面。
And a few days ago, a lot of brothers and sisters have written this prayer request in this cupa.
这一些祷告文呢，大家都看到，有目可以看到，这些都在 一个 Sukkot 里面，就是神的同在里面，神的居所里面。
And we can see that it is in the dwelling place of God under this kupa.
所以当我们的祷告献上去的时候，我们的心，我们的祷告也在神的同住里面。当这些刚跟神同住，什么都可以了，什么都成就了。
So as we offer our prayer request to God, our heart is also together with God, and therefore God will surely answer our prayers.
真的在神的殿中一日，胜过在世上千日啊。
A day in the house of God is better than 10,000 days outside.
所以神的一个祝福好过我们几十年的劳苦啊。
One blessing from God is better than 10 years of toiling and just working for it.
所以让我们一同渴慕神的同住。
Let's come and desire for God to dwell with us.
也一起同心的来建造神的殿宇。
And we work hard to build the house of prayer.
我们一起来敬拜神。
Let's come and worship our God.
所以弟兄姐妹，好吧，我们就这个时候就一起起立。
Yes, brothers and sisters, let's all rise to our feet.
我们来到神的宝座面前。
And let's come to the throne of God.
来献上我们的祷告。
And to offer our prayers.
来献上我们的赞美。
Offer our praises.
我来到你宝座，献上我的祷告，在这宁静时刻。我听见你的声音，因为你的爱已经找到了我，使我配得走进你的同在里。在这安静时刻，你聆听我呼求，享受在你的荣耀圣洁中，求你扬起脸来光照我的心，你是我心充满了快乐，主啊，你是我全然信靠，耶和华是我安然居住。我来到你宝座，献上我的祷告，在这宁静时刻，我听见你的声音，因为你的爱已经找到了我，走进你的同在里。在这安静时刻，你聆听我呼求，享受在你的荣耀圣洁中，求你扬起脸来光照我的心，你是我心充满了快乐，主啊，你是我全然信靠，耶和华是我安然居住。求你扬起脸来光照我的心，你是我心充满了快乐，主啊，你是我全然信靠，耶和华是我安然居住。
在这第八节里面
，At verse eight，
耶和华，求你兴起和你有能力的约柜同入安息之所。
Arise, O Jehovah, to your resting place, you and the ark of your strength.
愿你的祭司披上公义，愿你的圣民欢呼。
Let your priests be clothed with righteousness, and let your saints shout for joy.
求你因你仆人大卫的缘故，不要厌弃你的受膏者。
For your servant David's sake, do not turn away the face of your anointed.
感谢神，这三节里面。
Give thanks to God that in these three verses.
我们知道，大卫的后裔已经来了。
We know that David's descendant has already come.
就是耶稣基督。
He is Jesus Christ.
这是他的后裔，永远坐在大卫的宝座上。
And this is the descendant who is seated on the throne of David forevermore.
而是他真的是上帝的受膏者。
And he is truly the anointed one of God.
因为他是那个的，耶稣基督是那救主。
Because Jesus Christ is the Savior.
所以我们如果我们都相信主耶稣的。
So all those who believe in Jesus.
我们跟他跟大卫的这个永恒的约有份。
We have a portion in the covenant of David.
而且我们感谢神，我们可以因为耶稣基督，我们可以进入这一切一切。
And we give thanks to God that because of Jesus, we can enter into all this covenant.
我们可以披上这个的公义的袍。
Be clothed with righteousness.
我们也可以成为那圣民。
And we can become the holy people.
我们可以在我们这殿中，我们可以欢呼，我们可以一起来敬拜。
We can shout for joy and also to worship God in His sanctuary.
所以很多时候我们也很盼望我们有机会可以去到耶路撒冷一起来敬拜。
And often we also desire to go to Jerusalem to worship there.
感谢神。
Give thanks to God.
我们在耶稣基督里面找到一切都可以成就。
In Jesus, we find that all things can be accomplished.
谢谢神。
Give thanks to God.
给我们有这样的一个的美好的救恩。
To give us this wonderful salvation.
我们一起来感恩。
Let's come and give thanks.
我们一起来感谢神。
Let's come and
我们用祷告来感恩。
And we thank God with our prayers.
主啊，你帮助我们。
Lord, you help us.
能够看到那个的永恒的救恩。
That we can see this eternal salvation.
这就是在耶稣基督里面成就了一切。
That has been accomplished in Jesus Christ.
在他有公义的袍。
In He there's the cloth of righteousness.
我们也有这个公义的袍。
And likewise, we also have this robe of righteousness.
因为他在十字架上所成就的一切。
And because of everything that has accomplished on the cross.
主耶和华，求你兴起。
Jehovah God, may you arise.
和你有能力的约柜同入安息之所。
You and the ark of your strength into your resting place.
我们能够进入他的安息。
We can enter into his rest.
当我们来到敬拜神的时候。
As we come and worship God.
当我们来与神相交的时候。
As we come and also interact with God.
特别来到圣殿。
Especially coming to His temple,
我们可以有这个美好的一个安息。
We have this wonderful rest.
主啊，谢谢你。
Lord, we give thanks to you.
因为了有主耶稣，我们有这个全然的安息。
And because of you, we have this total and wholesome rest.
谢谢你，主耶稣。
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
你差派了你的主耶稣基督来到我们当中。
You have sent Lord Jesus to our midst.
成为那个受膏者。
To become the anointed one.
叫我们所有一切相信你的。
That all those who believe in you.
我们有了这个永恒的盼望。
We have this eternal hope.
我们也可以有一天回到那个永恒的居所里面。
That one day we shall return to the eternal dwelling place.
我们可以彼此的见面。
We can see each other once again.
主啊，谢谢你，主耶稣。
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
与我们同在。
To be with us.
保守祝福我们这里每一个人
Protect and bless all of us
垂听我们众人的祷告
Listen to our prayers
奉耶稣基督的名字
In Jesus my name we pray
Amen
Amen
求主祝福你们每一个
Bless all of you
祝福在网上一起跟我们晨祷的弟兄姐妹
Bless brothers and sisters who are attending the morning devotion
祝福我们每一天的的工作和休息
And bless our works and also our rest
谢谢主
Thank you, Lord.
垂听我们众人的祷告。
Listen to the prayers of the multitude.
奉耶稣基督的名字。
In Jesus' my name we pray.
Amen.
Amen.
谢谢大家。
Thank you, everyone.